Drums, please!
A groove slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm, just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance? Give me a soft, subtle mix, and if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And think of the summers of the past, adjust the bass and let the alpine blast. Pop in my CD and let me run a rhyme, and put your car on cruise and lay back, cause it's summertime. School is out and it's sort of a buzz, but back I didn't really know what it was, but now I see what habit is, the way that people respond to summer madness. The weather is hot and girls are dressing less and checking out the fellas to tell them who's best. Riding around in your Jeep or your Benzos, or in your Nissan sitting on Lorenzo's. Back in Philly we be out in the park, a place called the Plateau is where everybody go. Guys out hunting and girls doing likewise, honking at the honey in front of you with the light eyes. She turn around to see what you beeping at. It's like the summer's a natural aphrodisiac, and with a pen and pad I compose this rhyme to hit you and to get you equipped for the summertime. It's late in the day and I ain't been on the court yet. Get me a short set. Yeah, I got on sneaks, but I need a new pair, cause basketball courts in the summer got girls there. The temperature's about 88. Hop in the water plug, just for old time's sake. Break to your crib, change your clothes once more, cause you're invited to a barbecue to start at 4. Sitting with your friends as y'all reminisce about the days growing up and the first person you kiss. And as I think back, makes me wonder how the smell from a grill can spark off nostalgia. All the kids playing out front, little boys messing around with the girls playing double dutch, while the DJ spinning a tune as the old folks dance at your family reunion. Then 6 o'clock rolls around, you just finished wiping your car down. It's time to cruise, so you go to the summertime hangout. It looks like a car show. Everybody come looking real fine, fresh from the barbershop or fly from the beauty salon. Every moment frontin' and maxin', chillin' in the car, they spend all day waxin', leanin' to the side, but you can't speed through 2 miles an hour, so everybody sees you. There's an air of love and of happiness, and this is the Fresh Prince's new definition of summer madness.
Virtual Rebelations Assembly. My name is Charlotte.
And my name is Myah, and we hope you enjoy, and we are so excited to celebrate our year.
To start off, we are going to begin with a few words from Mr. Hume.
Hello, Eastwood. Well, I can assure you that this school year will be one that you never forget. We have come to the end of a school year that took place in the middle of a global pandemic unlike any other for the past 100 years. For that fact alone, it is reason enough for us to get together, virtually, and celebrate. Let me begin the celebration by recognizing all those who helped make this event happen. So you are aware, a group of dedicated teachers and students met for over a month to make sure that the year-end Rebelations Assembly would take place. Virtual round of applause for them. Of course, we are all here to celebrate the successes of our hardworking and determined students. and we will recognize their accomplishments in extracurriculars and academics. But I also encourage you to take some time to celebrate you. Often we are so busy living our lives that we forget to pause, reflect, and celebrate how much each of us has grown and accomplished. Maybe your reason to celebrate was because during a global pandemic, you did the best that you could. Let's face it, learning from home is not easy. You don't have your peers, you don't have your teacher, your classroom, your team, your bandmates, your club, your library resources, and even all that stuff in your locker. And you still found a way to keep learning. But the celebration does not have to be limited to your schoolwork. Maybe you learned to bake and started leaving cupcakes at your friend's door. Maybe you improved your level of patience as you took care of your little brother or sister while your parents were at work. Maybe you got to know your neighbors better and learned to appreciate their kindness. Maybe the death of George Floyd and the importance of the Black Lives Matter movement helped you find your voice around issues of social justice. Maybe you're determined to learn more about racism and work to change the world you live in because you realize your actions and your voice matter. So today, take time to cheer on and congratulate your peers, but don't lose sight of your own accomplishments, your own victories, and your own growth. I know each of you grew in some way this year, and that needs to be celebrated. The theme of today's Rebelations Assembly is Better Together. This past Sunday was National Indigenous Peoples Day. I learned that the Anishinaabe people use the word Mamawe to describe what it means to be together and celebrate. Mamawe is a recognition that there is a human need to find time to be with one another and recognize each other for the gifts each of us brings to the world. Although right now being together means staying apart, we want to take the next hour to recognize and celebrate your peers, but also make sure each of you find some time to celebrate you. So let's get started, Eastwood. We the East.
It's pretty crazy to think about life pre-COVID, but it's also pretty sweet. Here's a look at our year together before our extended March break.
I wish somebody would have told me that someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget. All these reckless nights you'll regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up, I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Oh, I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, hey. To hold it in for a while, hey. Standing with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child.
Hey, Shark.
Huh?
You know what I miss about Eastwood? The random, awesome dancing and singing around the hallways.
Me too. Well, here's a quick music fix for you. Next up, we are going to share with you one of the songs that the first semester songwriting class made.
Oh, when your head gets dizzy and you can't get a ride. Oh,
And we're going to take a quick trivia break. Tamara and I are going to ask you a few questions, and we'll post the answers in the comments below. So, to start off, first question is, how many different languages are spoken by the students in this year's graduating class?
I'm not sure. How many do you think, Charlotte?
I don't know.
I'm not sure. What are your guys' guesses down below? Okay, I'll ask the next one now, and we'll put the answers on there, too. Which Eastwood sports team has won the Wixa and Kwasa championship for 3 years straight in the past 5 years?
I think I know that one.
I think I know that one, too. Okay, I think people probably guessed by now. Charlotte, do you want to ask the next question?
Which musical was postponed due to a snowstorm in April?
I remember that one. That was, I think our musicals are a little bit doomed. Ice storm, COVID, always being postponed. Do you guys know what musical it is? Comment down below. Okay, here's the next question. What animal made a special appearance during an extended fire drill in 2019?
I definitely know this one.
That was a crazy day. I think that was definitely a crazy day. Okay, so I think those are our trivia questions for now, right, Char? Awesome. So we hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you learned something new about Eastwood. And if you didn't see the answers, check out the comments below.
Up next, we have a highlight reel of some of the award winners this year. Keep the scroll.
In a galaxy far, far away. Well, not really. Let's try this again. In a high school. Well, not in per se. We are social distancing at home. Here we go. Temp 3. In pajamas, at home, 2 meters away from others. Let's take some time to recognize the greatness that is Eastwood. First up, Athletic Awards. Junior Male Athlete of the Year, Nathan Paul. Junior Female Athlete of the Year, Emma Blake. Graduating Male Athlete of the Year, Josh Oakes. Graduating Female Athlete of the Year, Justine Vogan. Next, let's celebrate the academic achievements. Grade 9, Gold, Zoe Kirch. Silver, Peter Regal. Grade 10, Gold, Hannah Neary. Silver, Sidney Farrell. Grade 11, Gold, Myah Robinson. Silver, Tim Pham. Grade 12, Gold, Maggie Barker. Silver, Nicholas Layton. Let's not forget the math awards. Ed Baumgart Award, Nicholas Layton. Eastwood Math Elites, Brianna Burt, Jessica Turner, Zina Gulam, Agram Garotra, and Amy Vanderland. Wait, there's more. Here are our arts awards. Music Leadership Award, Chad Fulford and Olivia Power. Music Extracurricular Award, Patrick Cho. Drama Virginia Lee Award, Olivia Silva. Dance Participation Award, Belle Lemieux Chan. Dance Leadership Award, Maggie Barker. Dance Extracurricular Award, Jessica Turner. Visual Arts Leadership Award, Jillian Jiang. Visual Arts Extracurricular Award, A.D. Mason. Arts Council Outstanding Achievement, Jane Bach. Arts Council Leadership Award, Caitlin Cook. IAP Super 12 Outstanding Commitment, Sidney Hiemstra and Jake Evans Whitley. Lastly, we have the White E winners. These special White E's are awarded to those students who show outstanding ability, commitment, and extraordinary contribution to a club or activity. Make sure to follow along and congratulate these outstanding students. Congratulations to all. You are our top academic, athletics, and arts rebels and deserve a big round of applause.
Our students work so hard, and we are so excited to celebrate that work. Here are a few students who've gone above and beyond.
Hello, Eastwood Rebels. Mr. Parkinson and I are here today to talk to you about the Citizenship Award. What does citizenship mean? It really means being a member of a supporting one's community and country, and giving back to our Eastwood community is so important. What are the qualifications for this award? You must be a student in your his or her final year and have given extracurricular leadership throughout those years, have a good academic standing, and have been a good school citizen. These students were chosen by your teachers as those that have represented all of these qualifications throughout all of the years. So well done.
And ladies and gentlemen, in honor of Eastwood basketball going to OFSA once again, in honor of my Toronto Raptors still in June being reigning NBA champions, without further ado, the winners of the Citizenship Award team are... Give it up for Madison Fallows! Zina Ghulam! Sidney Hiemstra, Jillian Jung, Augustina Lasarte Villa, Matthew Lisk. And last but not least, Dietrich, a.k.a. Diet Rich Regal. Congratulations to our starting lineup, our Citizenship Award winners.
Thank you, thank you so much for giving back to our Eastwood community. You truly have been rock stars as an Eastwood Rebel.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to our Global Citizen Award. This is one of the Citizenship Awards that Impact is proud to help work with. Impact is Eastwood's environment club that works with social action, and our whole philosophy is about thinking globally but acting locally. We have a mantra that is one that we always say, citizens of tomorrow, today. We would like to recognize somebody who has worked really hard to walk the walk in this particular mindset.
And that brings us to this year's winner, who is Alicia Nowak, who has been a rock star. Yay! Alicia has been amazing acting locally on global issues. Started in a grade 9 geography class when we did the school recycling, and she identified the massive amount of styrofoam and plastic that was being produced by local restaurants, and ended up creating a petition and contacted that restaurant and went to that restaurant and worked with them. And over a couple of years, eventually, that project led to them switching to reusable and compostable materials. So that's an amazing example of someone who identified an issue, I think it's amazing, took action on it and made a huge change and impact in our community, which has a global impact as well. And I really am excited to honor her this year with this award, because that is exactly what this award is about. So congratulations. We hope you carry this on after your time at Eastwood and make an impact in the world around you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the idea with this award is that it's not only what you've learned in class or your participation in clubs, but it's about that continued action piece, that you continue to have tricky conversations in the community and help people be more conscious of their footprint, to make small changes that make big differences. And we are super proud of the work that you have done during your time, both in class and your ability to extend it into our community with thought and action. So congratulations, Alicia, for being this year's winner.
Congratulations.
Hey, Lillie, are you going to count me out? Ready?
And scene.
Mean it's good.
Good. Good. Good. Good. It's a fact. Have an impact.
Hello, everybody. So now we are at a point in the assembly live stream where we will be recognizing the hours and hours of hard work of people who have earned a Silver E. So to earn a Silver E, the requirements are that you have achieved a minimum of 5 white E's in your time at Eastwood. One of them needs to be a participation E. A participation E alone is 550 points. So these people have devoted hours into the school, and we thank you for that. They are, in many cases, double or triple majors in the arts program, participating in more than one area within those arts groups. They have been on cabinet, junior leadership, impact. So we really want to recognize the hours and devotion that you put into achieving this award.
This year's Silver E winners are Megan Butcher.
Patrick Cho.
Caitlin Cook.
Ryan Hackbart.
Lena Hart.
Jillian Jung.
Hunter McIntyre.
A.D. Mason.
Pepper Merlihan.
Zoe McCandless.
Selena Walkerton. Congratulations to all the Silver E winners. You truly have put tons of efforts into becoming an Eastwood Rebel. Thank you for all your hard work. We appreciate it.
Hey, Rebels, we hope that you've been coping well with all of these new changes.
We've missed seeing your faces around school.
Bayush and I have loved being your co-PMs this year, and we're really going to miss being with you next year.
We are super excited for your new co-PMs, and we know you're going to have an amazing year next year.
We named this year the Year of Us, and our hope was to bring everyone together and celebrate us as a school community.
Unfortunately, we couldn't be together these past few months, but these crazy times have given us things to bond over. It will definitely be a year to remember.
As fellow graduates, we are wishing all of our grads the best of luck in the upcoming years.
We know that you are going to do amazing things, and we hope that everyone keeps in touch.
And although we're all starting the new chapters of our lives, we hope that you know you will always have a family here at Eastwood.
To other grades, we wish you the best of luck in your final years at Eastwood. Take advantage of every opportunity and have fun.
We hope that you all have an amazing summer, and we hope that we'll get to see you again soon.
Be sure to keep in touch. We would love to chat with you.
Thanks for a great year.
Here we go.
Hello, Rebels. Mr. Parkinson here, along with Miss Jumeian. We are doing this virtually. And thank you, Lauren and Bayush, for your kind words and inspirational message. We are here to present the Co-Prime Minister Appreciation Award. And of course, Co-Prime Ministers would be nothing without Cabinet as well.
And we're here to talk about the Year of Us and what a year it was. Let's look back on some memories and look back at what was a great year.
First day of school, of course, grade nines come in, become official Eastwood Rebels, and there's Cabinet and the Rebel Rousers to help welcome them into the most amazing school, Miss Jumeian.
That's right. Look how excited they are. It was an awesome day.
Of course, September is very busy with lots of stuff going on, and Terry Fox run is one of the highlights for me. Terry Fox is Canada's greatest hero. Lots of money being raised, lots of people participating, and honoring Terry Fox's memory.
Again, another great day celebrating all the rebel spirit.
September is also busy. We have our first spirit assembly. We have many spirit assemblies. We love doing the Hey Baby dance. I love it, at least. And we celebrate all sorts of good stuff. Lots of spirit.
And look at that. Parkinson sporting the socks. I love it.
I don't know where you dug those up, Miss Jumeian. Hey, big shout out to Tech Crew. This is a shot that looks pretty empty, but Tech Crew is behind the scenes, and we're getting ready for the spirit assembly before we call people down. So Lauren's directing traffic. We got Gabriel there on Tech Crew. We're going over the performances. Awesome floor and awesome logo, by the way.
That's right. Looking good with all the lighting. So thank out, shout out for Tech Crew. Good job. Always our spirit assemblies are always amazing. I think we do the best job. And Tech Crew is a big part of that. So shout out to Tech Crew.
And they deal with our last minute requests very well. Hey, fall ball. We had a great fall ball school dance in the cafeteria nonetheless. And it was fantastic. Well attended. Lots of beats. Fletch, of course, on the DJ on the ones and twos, and what a time.
What a great night it was. People all dressed up, and it was great to have our dance at our school. Lots of fun.
Halloween's always a big hit at Eastwood, and look at that staff, great staff. Pac-Man theme this year. You know we killed it.
That's right, and look at those students dressed up as well. We always have the best costumes at Eastwood.
I love looking at the costumes. Hey, and also Halloween is our annual haunted cafeteria. So there's our haunted cafeteria and spooky movie night. Big shout out to Logan Brido, who worked everything behind the scenes, and our great students who participated.
It was spooktacular. Ooh. Love it. Ooh. It was a great night.
We'll skip ahead a little bit. There's lots of stuff going on in between, but Festivus, hey, Mr. Beer, nice sweater, by the way. Festivus was a great week raising cheer, and it ended with a holiday assembly and an alumni basketball game. Fantastique.
Thumbs up to all those people who helped out with Festivus. Great job. And that leads us into the following year, actually into the new year, with our bigger events of semi-formal.
Semi-formal was great. We sold out. Fine-looking people dressed up. It was well-attended. Great times.
Always a good night. We had a great time. Always so happy to see our rebels dressed up and having a great night.
This year we formed our first Black Student Union. Awesome times. And gave a good voice to our students. And then we brought in Orlando Bowen to further that. And Orlando Bowen has an awesome, awesome message. If you haven't heard him, well, everyone heard him. But Miss Jumeian, one voice?
One team.
What a powerful message. One of my favorite speakers.
It was a great day. His message really resonated with a lot of our students. Happy to have him at Eastwood.
And of course, before 2020 turned into a dumpster fire, we did end our last major event with our annual Black History Month assembly. Always well organized, lots of great energy, and we learned a lot too. Lots of fun. Really, really proud of you guys.
That's right. We always look forward to that day, and it's a great way to celebrate that Black History Month. Good job.
Of course, that was the end of February, and then March happened, and 2020 turned into COVID, and we got cut short. Nonetheless, Bayush Golla and Lauren Simmons, congratulations. You represent all of what's best at Eastwood. We have great arts. Lauren's a great dancer and involved in the arts program. Bayush is in her PM speech, I think, her mom's wildest dream, which is fantastic. Not born in Canada, came to Canada, and now co-PM. Played on the basketball team, played sports. It represents a lot of what makes Eastwood great, doesn't it, Miss Jumeian?
They do. They really were a great team together, and we couldn't have been prouder. So thank you so much, Bayush and Lauren, for all your hard work.
We will miss you. Leading into next year, Miss Jumeian, hey, we had lots of people applying for co-prime minister, but next year is going to be weird because we don't know what's going to happen. So rather than have an election, which we're not going to do, what did we do, Miss Jumeian?
We decided to have an online interview process where we decided to find what our co-prime ministers would look like, depending on, we had our teachers and our admin that had an interview process that we chose these lovely students to become our further co-prime ministers for the 2020-2021 year.
So congratulations to Cleo, Sasha, Myah, and Rory. We're excited to work with you. And of course, not just you, we're excited to work with all of Eastwood Cabinet and then all of Eastwood. You students, we're going to rock it. It's going to be challenging, but we're not afraid. We're going to do this, Miss Jumeian.
Looking forward to a great year. And I know we have a great team here to help us get us through the way.
Take care. Congratulations one more time, Cabinet, Lauren, Bayush, and our new co-prime ministers. And stay safe, Rebels.
We really have the best staff at Eastwood. The students thank you all for your hard work. We have a few awards and words for our awesome staff. Check it out.
Socially distancing, socially distancing, Eastwood.
Eastwood staff, quarantining together. One house. This is socially distancing.
Are they here yet?
I am so excited! This is gonna be good!
This is gonna be great. I'm super excited. Can't wait to get to know everybody better. It's going to be amazing.
I am so looking forward to getting to know the staff better. Maybe having some great crazy eight games, some crib. Man, I could use this time right now to get practicing.
Day one, woohoo! Everyone's here and so happy to be together. People are talking about going for long walks and game nights. Honestly, I really think people are just going to try to make the best of it, and these couple of weeks are just going to fly by.
So, it's day one. When we heard about the quarantine, they said it was going to last at least a couple weeks, and they told us that it's probably better if we just all stay together, so I'm pretty excited. I get to spend this time with all my colleagues.
Anyone coming?
been great. I mean, yesterday someone put ketchup on their homemade mac and cheese, which is super gross.
Who was it?
I'm not telling you.
Wrong again. New math. I quit.
New math made my mom quit. I'm your new teacher, Mrs. Waters.
We've been in here just over a week, and the big thing that's happening right now is someone is eating Doyle's food.
Again, someone has eaten my food again. Look, my name's right on it.
There are suspicions out there. But it's Helmer.
I don't know what to do. If I catch the person who's doing this, I'm gonna. And then I'll see if they're still hungry.
I think it's Helmer.
I heard it was Helmer.
Doyle's don't touch?
I don't know. The guy's a vegan. I'm so hungry I would even eat tofu. I'm checking this out. What the heck? Summer sausage. The guy's a poser. He's no vegan.
Doyle's. Don't touch. I wonder what it is. Let's check it out. Cookies. Yeah. We'll take one of those. He won't miss it.
Doyle's. Don't touch.
Oh, Steve. History teachers. You think that they would learn from history? Repeating itself and all that stuff.
So, no one's annoying you, or?
Well, there is a loose dog in the house. And no one knows who it belongs to. But I'm fine. I'm totally fine.
Well, it's day 19 of the house and some weird stuff is happening.
What do you mean?
Well, for starters, someone keeps stealing Doyle's food, and Jen hasn't changed out of her pajamas in like a week.
Where's Verhoeve?
Haven't seen him.
Nah, I haven't seen him in days.
Man, people are starting to lose it. I'm thinking some are gonna try to escape.
What are you doing?
With you!
Oh, hey, Vicky. How's it going?
Why are you talking to me so early?
It's like 2 p.m.
Bernard? What is she doing? That's so embarrassing.
Oh, the sink's clogged again. Oh, what the? Oh, is that hair? Oh, it's not my problem.
It's really hard. Yesterday, Elise tried to escape, and I heard someone crying in the shower.
I can't go out. I can't get away.
I heard there's been some drama between the phys ed people and the artsies.
Stop fighting. We're rebels. We're supposed to build each other up, not tear each other down.
To be honest, this whole thing started up just fine. Well, not fine. As fine as a world pandemic can be. But we did what we had to do. And what we had to do was just stay in this house. You know, at first it was fun to relax. Play some games. Do some yoga. It's been so many weeks and people have started to argue and show frustration at not having things exactly as they want. Which I get. You know, these are not normal circumstances. I've learned to appreciate the friendships and recognize the need to reach out to people when they're hurting. The other day, Parky made coffee and tea for all of us. All of us. It was so nice. And we even rallied together to go find Verhoeve. People have started to show some kindness to one another, and we should focus on that. Times have been rough, yes, but we've also become closer. We are stronger than ever. I just wish that everyone saw that the way that I'm starting to. I don't think I'm going to forget this experience for as long as I live. I'm thankful for my colleagues, my friends. That's what they are, they're friends. And us rebels, we take care of each other. And now I know that we can make it through anything. We got this.
When this is over, can you come get me? Which direction? East. East!
What?
I've gotta go. East!
What? East!
What?
East 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 what?
Eastwood.
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 Lovely artists.
Hello, lovely artists.
Hello, lovely artists.
Today we would like to recognize a member of our staff who has gone above and beyond in their contributions to extracurricular life at Eastwood.
This teacher has spent so many hours dedicating themselves to their students and making our time at Eastwood a little more magical.
From many weekends spent painting sets for the musical, to the hours spent on Google Meet finding ways to celebrate her students, this teacher loves being an Eastwood Rebel and is so dedicated to her craft.
Thank you, Ms. Gruber, for all that you do. You're so much more than a teacher.
You are a mentor, a friendly face, and a cheerleader.
A friend and an inspiration.
Thank you for guiding us, inspiring us, and making us who we are today.
We would like to congratulate you on your year of hard work and present you with this year's Extracurricular Staff Award.
Thank you for everything you do.
Thank you for everything you do.
Thank you for everything you do. We love you, Gruber.
Thank you for everything you do.
Of course, it's always better together, but goodbyes are a reality of life. We want to take some time now to recognize and celebrate the Eastwood staff members who are moving on. Whether they're retiring to the good life, seeking out new opportunities, or hoping to pick up a contract position in the Waterloo Region District School Board, good luck LTOs, we wish them all the best and thank them for their contributions here at Eastwood.
Tammy Rogerson has had a profound impact on Eastwood vocal students, not just in musical skill, knowledge, and appreciation, but also the personal impact, which has been one of the greatest gifts she was able to give these students. Her conducting is a marvel to watch. Her musicality is phenomenal, and she has incredibly high standards of excellence, and the level of theory and history knowledge that our vocal students have left Eastwood with is unmatched in the region. Tammy Rogerson has successfully helped raise the profile of the choral vocal program here at Eastwood to a provincially and nationally recognized level, and our current students and staff will definitely miss her. Miss R would like to leave us with a quote from Dr. Bonnie Henry, Provincial Health Officer of BC, who says, "Be kind, be calm, be safe." And one from Canadian comedian Rick Mercer, who said, as commentary to the many Zoom calls where people have been dressing only from the waist up, "Wash your hands, wear pants."
Daryl Woodward taught construction and green industries most recently, but also math, student success, special ed, and at one time he was acting head of special ed for us. Daryl was utterly selfless with his time and in his efforts to engage many of our most reluctant learners. He taught with energy, curiosity, and brought the kind of wisdom to lessons and conversations that only someone with his rich life experiences could bring. If you know Daryl, then you know that he embodies what it means to be a lifelong learner. He is a mentor and my friend, and I will miss him. Daryl sent along a note for me to read to you. "Teaching is a noble profession, and I am truly honored to have been part of it. I thank all those who have been part of my growing and learning as a teacher, but the time has now come for me to be a full-time student again. Cheers!"
As he moves on to new adventures and literal greener pastures out in the country at Waterloo, Oxford, Mr. King will be missed for all of the ways that he's left his mark on ECI in the past 14 years. Mr. King has shared his love of history and passion for politics with students in his classroom. He created an engaging law program complete with walks to the courthouse and guest speakers. He taught Eastwood's hockey course and coached football, curling, and hockey. And he ran mock trial in Fed Prov. If you've been in Mr. King's classroom, you know that history isn't learned from textbooks, but by making paper airplanes, reenacting trench warfare, and dancing the Charleston. Come September, we will miss hearing his bombastic voice echo through the second floor hallway and his friendly razzing of students and staff alike. Mr. King, as you leave to seize the day at WO, always remember that from the East comes light, and you will always have a home at ECI.
Mr. Dandy was a physical education teacher and track and field coach while at Eastwood. He'll be teaching at SJM next year.
We just wanted to say a formal thank you to all of the staff members that have helped make this situation a little bit easier.
Hours you spent preparing lessons, trying to adjust to this change is greatly appreciated. Here's a round of applause for all of you. Next up, we would like to celebrate our grads. Enjoy this video.
Hello, class of 2020! This your Cookie Mensment speaker, Cookie Monster, here to congratulate you on graduation! Me know it's a challenging time right now, and you getting deal rawr'd and cookie dough. No graduations, no parties, no awkward family photos in your cap and gown, but me so impressed because all of you are showing that you some pretty tough cookies. And don't worry, cause me prepared an inspiring speech perfect for occasion. You gonna love it.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Where me speech? Okay, apparently me ate inspirational speech. But that okay, because this actual life lesson, yeah. Always be ready to wing it.
2020. Cheers.
And sometimes you may eat your own words. So that's actually two lessons. You know, you are all a lot like cookies. Yeah. Yeah, you know, there are even two cookies in 2020. Cookie. Cookie. You graduates have all the ingredients for an amazing future. Just like the ingredients in a cookie! Your knowledge, your ABCs and 1-2-3s is kind of like your flour, a base that allows you to bake and create cookies or anything you want. And you're also like butter. Me never met a class so slick. You as smooth as a baking sheet. Thanks to you, me wearing high-waisted jeans again. Yeah. And me know more dance moves than the cookie shuffle. Next, we have the chocolate chippies. That's your sweetness and kindness. The way you care about helping others and making this a sweet world to live in. Mwah. And me know it's a little crummy right now, but like eggs, you may get cracked, but you always bake and rise up to face challenges in front of you. And you put that all together with a dash of vanilla and maybe some raisins if you into that sort of thing and a bunch of other things that me forgot. Me cookie eating expert, not cookie baking expert. And we have you, a perfectly prepared, baked and well-rounded cookie. Class of 2020, remember to eat a lot of cookies. Yeah. And a few veggies, and follow your own recipe. Me hat off to you, if me had a hat, but me ate that too. So me cookie off to you, you smart, well-rounded cookie, you. You the best of the batch. Congratulations and cheers, class of 2020. Clink. Yeah, good luck. Your future look delicious. And so does this cookie.
Ah, cheers to you, nom, 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 enjoy nom, those cookies.
Nom, 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 nom.
Hey Rebels, it's Alicia here. What I think that keeps us together in these times is definitely just knowing you're a part of the Eastwood community and having all the support from teachers and from our peers.
Hey, I'm Myah. I'm a grade 12 student at Eastwood and I am graduating this year. One thing that I've learned during my 4 years at Eastwood is that being a rebel is all about being part of a community, and that has been especially clear during this pandemic, because even though we can't meet face-to-face, we are still going out of our way to organize events and to keep the community alive. And I think that is what being a rebel really means.
Hi Eastwood, my name is Ismahan Muhammad and I am a grade 12 student at Eastwood and I will be graduating this year and attending Laurier in September. I'd have to say my favorite memory at Eastwood would probably have to have been at this year's Black History Month Assembly. I not only had the opportunity to co-plan it with the rest of the BSU club, but also co-host it. I'd have to say one thing I'm gonna miss about Eastwood would probably be how close-knit the school was. There was literally something for everyone at Eastwood, and Eastwood has been a home for so many students, including myself, and I really am gonna miss being at Eastwood.
Hello Rebels, my name is Jessica Turner. Even though we are apart, our school spirit is what keeps us together. Since arriving at Eastwood in grade 9, I have learned what true school spirit is, and I'm glad that I've been surrounded by it. At Eastwood, we are inclusive, we support each other, and we celebrate each other's successes. Our school has had so many amazing events, like school dances, spirit assemblies, and the various integrated arts program shows. I've been a part of so many clubs, and I've made fun memories with so many people that I will never forget. I'm sad that we were unable to say a proper goodbye, but I'm thankful for all of the experiences that the school has brought. Good luck to my fellow grads. I know you have a bright future ahead of you. Go Rebels!
such times like these, time and time again.
Let's go. It's times like these that we activate. Do something to improve, don't procrastinate. I've been cooking, I'll make a wicked pasta plate. Stream games at 11, but I clap at 8. And I'll jingle FaceTime if you tempt me. Time to pay back all the health docs lent me. And for me, West 10's elementary. But right now, I wanna see life go empty, you get me?
We'll make it better together. We'll make a better life. Because the pressure is ever upon us every night. And every day, so we pray.
Follows you back home.
Take care, stay safe, stay healthy, and I'll see you guys very soon. Mwah.
May not be coming at you from the room behind the steel window, but Eastwood Radio still has a final broadcast coming at you. Let's kick off the summer the way we always do. A few jokes, a little bit of Alice Cooper, and a whole lot of fun. Check out the Eastwood Collegiate YouTube on Friday at 2:20 p.m.
This is going to be a changing day in your life.
Yo, Eastwood Wagwan, good morning.
Jumbo, Eastwood.
Swahwanaxen, Eastwood.
Guten Morgen, Eastwood.
Bonjour, Eastwood.
Shubprabhat, Eastwood.
Subhaparvat, Eastwood.
Dobryutro, Eastwood.
Danadrachi, Eastwood.
Jiayanu, Eastwood.
Ohayo gozaimasu, Eastwood.
Buenos dias, Eastwood.
Sabah al-khair, Eastwood.
Good morning, Rebels.
It's another fabulous day at Eastwood.
3, 2, 1.
Myah, do you hear that?
Yeah. Is that what I think it is?
I think so.
It's the
rubrics.
Hey there, Eastwood. We are the rubrics. We are physically distancing on this beautiful day. We hope you're safe.
1, 2, 3. 6 feet away. Ooh,
don't you forget about me. I'll be at home marking, you know, baby. Tell me your troubles and doubts, then email in assignments for weeks in and out. Life's strange, we're all in the dark. Will you think of the things that we were working on? The virus may force us apart, but Eastwood's night is still in your heart, baby.
Grades ain't
lower your mark. Not with this novelty virus at large. Don't you forget about me. I'll be at home, marking it home, baby. Gonna check your weekly 3 hours. And I'll roll the mark together, baby. Don't you forget about East.
Tradition of ours.
It's not an Eastwood assembly without this.
Okay, señoritas y caballeros, and ladies and gentlemen, mighty diamonds and dead and hey, baby, from the 17th. Okay, put your hands up in the air, be hand in the air. Oh.